So these are the drilling whelks that drill holes in the shells of mussels and in fact a whole range of other mollusks. The animal opens and it has a little acid gland on its foot, and it applies that acid gland to the surface of the mussel shell, softens the shell, and then it scrapes away the softened tissue and then applies the acid gland again and then scrapes away again. And then after maybe 4 to 8 hours, it's actually made a complete hole through the mussel shell.
And then it sucks it from the inside.
And then, yes, it puts its proboscis, it's like an elephant's trunk with its teeth on the end. It puts that through the hole and then sucks out the tissue. So if you actually have an interesting little anecdote about this, is if you have a small whelk that attacks a big mussel, then it can actually feed as much as it wants and it's not enough to kill the mussel. So we call that non-fatal predation. So it'll put its proboscis through, eat a circle out of the tissue, which is mostly gonad, and then go away satisfied. And then the mussel will close up the shell and recover.
Oh, so it can do repairs?
Yes, it can do repairs. So I've actually found mussel cells which have been predated by whelks up to 4 times and have survived. They're still alive. So here are the whelks that bore into the mussel shell. There's one there, a second one there, and a third one there, and a fourth one there. It all looks like they're burrowing into a whole lot of different mussels here. So not a good place for mussels to be. Some of the other whelks that we've looked at actually drill holes in the shells of mussels and other mollusks, but most whelks are scavengers, so they just hang around in the rock pools, and they're smelling all the time for the smell of damaged or dead animals. And when they detect that smell, then they suddenly become active, and they'll start congregating. So over here, we've actually got a sea urchin which has been damaged. And a whole group of whelks that are emerging from little cracks and crevices around the rock pool and are converging on this damaged sea urchin. And they have their siphons, their smelling organs, up in the air. They're sniffing the water and then converging on the smell of this dead animal. And then they put their proboscis out and then start eating the flesh. And they'll clean it up in a very short period of time.
They're kind of like the vultures of the rock pools.
They're absolutely the vultures. They're acting in exactly the same way.
And there's quite a lot of, you know, like dead things would wash up and fall into rock pools.
Yes.
That sort of thing.
So any dead fish or decaying animal or the prey of an octopus or something like that, which it just leaves the shell, then they'll quickly gather around that and then clean up the bones, as it were.
I see they've also got this little like trapdoor.
Yes, you see, that's the trapdoor that closes up the shell. As soon as it's disturbed, it will retract back into the shell and then use the trapdoor to close up the opening.
What sort of thing would be preying on these?
So perhaps octopus, large fish, will prey on these. A lot of them also get caught by sea anemones when they get tumbled by the waves.